Hey guys, we are starting a new video session, that is the numerical problem in geology. The main reason behind which I had started this type of video session is that most of the entrance examination like JAM, GATE or whatever it is, it consisting of lots of numerical problems in geology. And basically in your syllabus, that is in your UG as well as in PG level, this type of numerical problems are very less. So I think this will be helpful for someone who are preparing for the competitive examination, and that's why I've just started this type of video classes. So this is the very first class in this heading, and in this I will try to solve some of the numerical problems from your previous year exam, and according to the response for this video you will try to do subject wise, that is like structural geology, then sedimentology, likewise you will try to solve. Okay. And if you want to search this type of videos, you can use the hashtag, that is hashtag geomath, that is geomath. If there is a lot of videos and if you want to search our video, you can also use the second hashtag, that is hashtag success guru. So if you use these two type of hashtags, you can simply search our mathematical videos that is related to geology and you can make use of it. Welcome to my channel Success Guru and myself Panchanatham, and let's get into the heading. So we'll solve the very first question, and this question is from GATE 2020, and that is also from part A. The question number is 21. A mid-oceanic ridge has symmetrical magnetic anomaly about the ridge axis as shown below. Using the information given in the figure, the average relative velocity between the plate A and B is calculated to be dash centimeter per year, and they are given the image here. So in this question, what they had asked, what they are given is actually the time duration and the distance. That is, you can see here the million year is the time duration and the distance is say 50 kilometer. And what they are asked for is the relative velocity between the plates. Okay. So let us solve this question. The formula for this question is very simple. That is, velocity is equal to distance by time. As they are asking for the velocity, that is the movement speed of the plate. And as we know the distance and time, we can calculate it by simply, that is 50 kilometer by 1 million annum. But in the question, what they are asked is, they are asked for centimeter per year, right? So we have to convert the kilometer into centimeter, and for that we have to multiply it, and what we will get is say 5 centimeter per year. So to convert kilometer to centimeter, what we have to do is we have to multiply the kilometer into 1000. So we will convert the kilometer to meter, then into 100, then we will get the centimeter value. So we have to multiply it by 1 lakh, that is with 5 zeros, 3 zero for meter and 2 zeros for converting it to centimeter. And in the question, what they are asked is the relative velocity. And to find the relative velocity between the two plates, what we have to do is to subtract the values of the two plates, that is the speed of the velocity, speed of the plates. Here in this case, what happens, the movement is in opposite direction. So we are using here the minus sign. So as you know, minus into minus is the plus. So the answer is 10 centimeter per year. So this is the relative velocity of the plates. Okay. And this is the second question, and this question is also from the GATE 2020. In this, they are given the geometric factor, they are asked for the geometric factor of the electrode configuration from the for the figure that is given below, and they are given the value for pi, that is 3.14. so what they are asked given is the electrode spacing, and what they are asked for is the geometrical factor. And the solution for this is this: the electrode configuration can be matched with the Schlumberger configuration. As you can see here, the spacing is uneven. In Wenner, you know, the spacings are even, that is this distance and this distance, and all the three distance are equal according to the Wenner configuration. In Schlumberger configuration, the distance is not equal. So we can use the Schlumberger configuration, that is A. Here A is the distance between the potential electrode, that is say 10 meter, and L is the distance between the current electrode, that is 20 plus 10 plus 20, so it is 50 meters here. And for the Schlumberger configuration, what is the geometric factor formula is K is equal to pi into L square minus A square by 4A. So we can simply substitute the value, the pi is 3.14, that is at given, and L is 50 and A is 10. So by substituting the value, what we can get is 188.4. So this is the geometric factor for this type of electrode configuration. Is that clear? Okay, we'll go for the next question. The next question is also from GATE. That is also from part A, and the question number is 25. A 4 km high plateau is isostatically compensated as shown in the figure. Assuming Pratt's hypothesis of isostasy, the calculated density of the plateau in kilogram per meter cube. So what they are given is the thickness and density of the plates. For actually there are two plates, they are given for one plate density and thickness, and for other plate they are given only the thickness but not the density. And what they are asked is you have to find out the density of that plate. Okay, and for that, according to the Pratt hypothesis, the product of the density and thickness of the lithosphere slab are isostatically equilibrium. That is what the statement of the Pratt's hypothesis. And according to that, you can see here the block one, that is you can consider this or this one, anything, you can use it as a block one. That is density into height should be equal to the blocks two density and height. So we can just simply substitute the value, you know, the block one's density, that is 2800 km per meter cube, and the height, that is the thickness, is 28 km. And for block two, we don't know the density, so we can keep it as A, and the height is say 28 plus 4, right? So we can use it as 32. So we have to just replace the number, that is 32. If it goes this side, there will be a division, right? So by substituting the value, we can get the density of the plateau, that is 2450 kilogram per meter cube. This is the answer for that question. And the next question is from part B, that is also from GATE 2020. The grade of iron ore in an ore body containing 80 weight percentage of hematite and 20 weight percentage of gangue is dashed. And they had given the atomic weight of Fe and the atomic weight of O. So what they had given is the weight percentage, and what they are asked for is the grade of the iron ore. So this sum consisting of two steps. So the first step is finding the individual weight percentage of the Fe. So we have to find the individual weight percentage of Fe. So Fe is equal to 2 into atomic weight of Fe, that is given in the question, that is 55.85, by 2 into atomic weight of Fe plus 3 into atomic weight of oxygen, as the composition of hematite consisting of Fe2O3, right? So Fe twice and oxygen thrice. That is why we are using 2 into atomic weight of Fe and 3 into atomic weight of oxygen. So we can just substitute the values from the question. And the answer for this weight percentage of Fe is 0.69994. So this is the very first step. And the second step, that is the finding the grade of the iron ore. What we have to do is, the iron ore content of the ore body is given as 80%. The grade of the ore is equal to the individual weight percentage into iron content. So as we know, the individual weight percentage is say 0.6994. And the iron content is say 80%, so we can use it as 0.8. As you know, percentage is divided by 100, so 80 by 100 will be equal to 0.8, and the answer is 55.95. So this is how we have to solve this question, right? So we have two steps: finding the individual weight percentage of iron, then we have to find the grade of the ore using the formula individual weight percentage into iron content. And the next question is that a vertical profile perpendicular to the crest line of an asymmetrical ripple is given in the figure. Okay, and we have to calculate the ripple index. This is the question. So what they had given is the length and height of the ripple, and what they had asked for is the ripple index. And as you know, the ripple index is equal to ripple's wavelength by ripple's height. Here the wavelength is the distance between the crest to crest or trough to trough. As they had given the distance between the trough to the crest, then crest to trough, what we have to do is we have to add both the things. So we will get the distance between the trough to trough, right? So in this case, the distance of lee side plus toss side will give you the wavelength, that is from trough to trough. So what we have to do is we have to add these two numbers. That will get you 250 millimeter, and the height is say 60 meter, that is in the question. So from the formula, ripple index is equal to 250 by 60, so the answer is 4. So this is a quite easy question, right? So this is the next question. This is also from GATE 2020, that is from part B. Confining aquifer as a uniform area, that is A, perpendicular to the water flow. The hydraulic gradient and coefficient of humidity are given as 0.005 and 2 meter per day respectively. The total daily flow of the water is say 250 meter square. Using Darcy's law, the calculate the value of A. So in this question, what they had given is the hydraulic gradient, hydraulic conductivity and the flow rate. And what they are asked is the area of cross section, that is the cross sectional area. And you know the law that governs the relation between the these four components is the Darcy's law. According to that, Q by A is equal to K by I. In this formula, Q stands for the flow rate, A stands for the area of cross section, and K stands for the hydraulic conductivity, and I stands for the hydraulic gradient. So we can simply substitute the values from the question, which is Q is equal to 250 and K is equal to 2 and I is equal to 0.005. So we can just simply cross multiply. You can keep the A in this side and you can bring this value this side. So A is equal to 250 by 2 into 0.005, which will give you 250 by 0.01, and the answer is say 25,000 meter square. That is the area of cross section of this aquifer. Is that clear? So if you are convinced with this calculation, and if you are clear with this calculation, I just want you to try this question. This is also from the GATE, that is also from part B. The question number is 30. The apparent dip amount of the sandstone bed is say 45 degree, and the angle between the true dip direction and the apparent dip direction is say 60 degree. The true dip amount of the bed is dash. This is the question, and if you want any help for this question, you can just check our previous video, which I have given the link in the description, or you can also use the I button from the top or right corner. And this is just a trial video, and according to the response for this video, we may continue this type of video. I hope you may be liking this video. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. I group my videos according to the category that you can check in my playlist. You can connect with us by mail, Facebook and Instagram. You can support us by like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.